first gotta say hello to YouTubes. And also I kind of use this as kind of a marker of saying, when does the recording actually start when I'm editing? And also I'm giving people a chance because I don't, oh hell, no, I'm missing one vital point. I'm missing my freaking phone. Hello YouTubes, I am Grimwit, this is Dark Souls. I am streaming as of April some kind of date or something, I can't remember. Anyway, first things first, I need to check my inventory, because if I already have it, then I don't need to get it, but I might not have it. I do have it, I have a longbow. I wish to switch over to the longbow. Is it really all that different? Because if not, then I will be keeping it. No, it really isn't all that different. Whoop, wrong button. It's been a whole week since I've played, which makes this fun. No, it's the same everything. Okay. Alright. Off the books, I was told what I was missing in Darkroot Garden, so I want to check that out first. And then it's going to be Sin's Fortress all the way. This is not a place I wanted to be. Oh, shit! Hi. God damn, am I gonna die here? Now? After all I've been through? Fun times were had by everybody. Everybody, every single one. Awesome. Saw through my ruse. Whoa, was that a one-hit kill? Hell yeah. I didn't know my sword was kind of ramped up that much. I have one-hit kills now. I love you, sword. You're awesome, sword. Never say die, sword. Oh, hell. Whoop. Always be pillaging. I'm probably gonna cut this part out. Wait. What are those? What is that? Is it some kind of fruit? Are they mushrooms? What is it supposed to be? Huh. Alright, well, whatever. Yeah, I'm going into unknown territory, so I should probably rest up. And the best bow is through this door, and I'm not ready for it. Or I might be ready for it. I don't know. And here we are again. So this tree is moving. Yep. And I completely missed this tree. This is the part that I thought I was missing before. I just didn't see it. I mean, it's camouflaged right. I went right past it. No idea it was there. What? What are you? What even are you? Wimpy is what you are. I don't know what a green blossom does. Make sure I'm safe before I check. Okay, nifty. Alright, what's a green blossom do? Temporarily boosts stamina recovery speed. Not sure when I'd use that, but alright. Exploratory. Quickly, towards that spinning tree! Oh, you can't fool me. I saw you spinning. Trees have feelings too, you guys. I hear people. Nope, I'm wrong. There was nobody here. Is that noise? I can't tell what's ambient noise and what's actually something trying to kill me. Not yet. Anybody who's played D&D knows you check the level you're on before you go down to the next level or up to the next dungeon level. Whoa! Ambush! Ambush! Oh my god, and there's a golem over there. Things just get better and better. I don't even remember pressing those buttons, but they did things. More green blossom. Loving the sword. What's this? Proud Knight Sword. And the DM throws monsters at you anyway. Hey, Wayne! I'm finishing up exploration of the Darkroot Garden. Because somebody outside of the game said, hey, yo, do you miss this tree? I mean, a tree that's not a tree? Are you gonna wake up? You're gonna wake up. I love you. Ow. Oh, got me on the backhand. Okay, well, there's nothing else around here. I figured that golem would be guarding something since it took him so long to wake up. Although, there is this area over here. Is there another corpse thing? No? Man, if this were Talos Principle, there'd be, like, Pac-Man references and Serious Sam references all over the place. Every nook and cranny holds a new reference to another video game. Two trees you need to kill. I've only killed the one so far. And then I kind of sidestepped around the other. We'll see if there's another tree up ahead. What up, my nigga? Can I say that? I'm Mexican. Now, I know I can't say it if I'm white, but I'm Mexican, so that's alright then, right? Hey, you should be dead by now. Don't cast spells when you're dead. Dead people don't do anything. Ah, this was that light I saw on the way here, and I think this is honestly the end of it. Wolf ring. I got the wolf ring. Hooray! What's the wolf ring? Let's take a look at it. I have Havel's ring right now, which is pretty awesome. Boosts poise. Wow, actually, that's pretty good. Wolfring belongs to Astoria the Abysswalker. I think you fight him later on. Unbendable Will of Steel. This would have been great with my last set. My last armor set. For now, I'm going to ignore it. And one of the best rings, you say. Actually, I will probably put it on if I start playing Dark Souls Fashion. Or Dark Fashion. Or Fashion Souls. I don't know what to call it. I believe that's pretty much everything over here. Let's just run into traps, get into trouble, run around in a circle, and see what's going on. There's not much else here. I've killed everything I need to kill. Sup, dude? How you doing? I'm sorry I killed your friend. Okay, I don't know where the second tree is. If this is the second tree, I haven't killed him. Her. It. But I did kill this tree over here. This is the goofiest thing. It's like a manta frog. A frog ray. Manta... Frey. Okay. No secrets over here, I don't think. Up the steps I go. I also took your advice and posted on the Let's Stream thread of Something Awful. Honestly, with that, I'm done here. I guess I could trigger this trap. It's clearly a trap. Oh my god, look at the bushes. These things are such traps. You can't fool me. Damn it. Just the three? Large soul of a nameless soldier. Huh. Wonder what his name was. Oh well. I think that's probably it for the Dark Root Garden. I mean, I even have the tower. Well, I guess there's this door as well, which I have learned via cheating and looking it up, that the best bow that I want is actually owned by somebody on this side. It's called something like the Faris's Black Bow, I think? Something like that. I don't know. For now, I got the long bow. Doing all right. Okay, I need to rest for a sec, and I need to check something outside of the game. Okay. That is what I was looking for. Put that on the side. And I guess it's back to Sin's Fortress. The only thing that's really changed is I have this longbow now. But other than that, I go back to the marble madness that is Sin's Fortress. And I try to defeat it with nothing but my will and grit and iron and gigantic brass boobs of steel. Hey guys, I'm down here. Why is it so hard to see you? All right, cool. Oh, it got me good. Notice I got him good too. Hey. Oh, I thought that was a butt stabbing. Ah, goddamn, stop moving. I want to stab your butt. I want to stab everyone's butts. For I am Madam Woohoo, the butt stabber. Okay, now there was one thing, I don't know who has it, but you were mentioning some arrows do good at long range, some arrows do good at short range. The large arrows apparently are excellent at short range. Feathered arrows are the best arrows for long range. But I'm going to stick with standard arrows simply because there's more of them. And you know what? Oh, God, I do want to go back and grab me some more arrows from Andre. But I won't, because I'm already here, and why not? Crash and burn, 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 crash and burn! Crash and burn some more! Crash and burn some more! Yes! Oh, glorious days. Sniping them to death, you say? I like that. I'm also told moon arrows. See, I had it in my mind that it was some kind of moonlight bow or some shit. Whoa! Oh, you got me good. Okay. That one's yours. That one's yours. I'll give you that. I had it in my head that I could use the soul of the giant butterfly. Ah, shit. I'm alive? Okay. Oh, I want to kill you so bad. It's hard to gauge where these goddamn things are swinging. Ah, shit! Well, if I had that 4,438 souls, I could buy arrows while I'm here. God damn it. How much are arrows again? They're like 50 souls per. If I go up and I kill some dude, that'll only give me like 20 souls. You know, let's just kill these guys right here. I'll reclaim my soul. Let me kill these two guys. Yes, that's usually what you get hit on that level. I'll kill these two guys. And then I'll use their souls to get more arrows. Damn. Remember what I said about using their souls to get... Yeah. Yeah, I guess I could use souls in my inventory to buy. That's good too. But I'm like a hoarder when it comes to hard souls. And I don't think I've ever used any of my hard souls yet. Nope, wrong one. Here we go. I have plenty of large souls of nameless soldiers, so let's use those and see how many we can get out of them. How many do they give? 1,000 per? Two of those will probably get me a decent number of arrows.
Well, I don't use it, need any.
Okay, large arrows. Not standard, but large. Okay. 40? Sounds good.
Don't get yourself killed.
I'm thinking the grass crest shield might be my shield for the rest of the game. In which case, I should probably start leveling it up as well. Oh, and thank you. Oh man, elixirs in Final Fantasy are so good. They're delicious, like cola. Oh hey, I can collect my nothing! It's Nice knowing you. Where's the other guy? Hey. Gotta keep a lady waiting? That's rude. He's wearing his friend! Oh, good times! Just because he's a boa doesn't mean you can wear him like one. Let's see here. Level it up so it gets more stable. Yeah. How much, because I gotta get Titanite to begin with. Just out of curiosity. Titanite, 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 Titanite. I have no Titanite. Oh wait, there it is. I have 3 Titanite. That's enough to level it up a decent amount. And that might be worth it just to grab. You know what, I am gonna go back to Andre. And I know it's just kind of like how much of watching a man run back and forth can you watch during a stream? But, they took out the ragdolls in 2? That's like the most fun part of Dark Souls, is the Havoc engine. That's almost blasphemous to take out the ragdoll. How are we gonna have silly things happen? Okay. Let's get a couple more going here. Because I suspect I might have to buy some Titanite shards to do this. Okay, reinforce, yeah? Reinforce armor? Weapon? Yes, it counts as weapon. Oh, and I did reinforce the weapon. I mean, the shield. Let's do it again. Okay, to get it up the next 2, I need 2. Let me buy, how many, 800 per? I knew it'd be a bit. Okay. So, physical defense is up. No, that's physical strike. Why wouldn't that? Anyway, stability is up by 1%. I don't think it upgraded like the percentage taken off of magical. No, it really didn't. It's just upgraded stability. But that's what I still want. Hey, what's up, Meatskitter? Hi, Meaty. I'm just going to call you Meaty. More Dark Souls. And I think you were what I did finish the Talos Principles. I don't know if you got to see that, Meaty, but, boink. But I haven't got all the stars on Talos Principles, so I'm gonna end up going back. Probably. I kinda really wanna play. Meat. I kind of want to play Ultima Exodus for nostalgia's sake because of... Oh, who was it? Somebody was doing the Let's Play of Ultima 1 on the forums, and it got me really nostalgic. Fall off, fall off, fall off, fall off, fall off. Falafel, fall off, fall off, so fall off. Yes, finally. All right. What does stability do? Is that like adding to poise? Or does that lower the amount of damage taken from endurance? Somebody died. Higher stability means less stamina drain. Awesome. That's what I was hoping it was. He's asleep. Where's the ball rolling? I don't remember where the ball is rolling. Is Onion Bro still down there? No, but that guy is. I'm not gonna jump down to get him. Dude, get up here. I can't really push him. Bye. Okay. So that's another guy down. Dunt. Another one bites the dust. Okay. I did not start this ball rolling. That wasn't me. I didn't do that. So what did? Was it this guy? It was this guy. It was totally this guy. Yo. Didn't quite work out the way I wanted it to. You work in certain places and it triggers. Hell, I don't want it to trigger. That means that it's now rolling this way now, right? Yep. And I remember this, because I can never get this right. I'm always dying here. Alright, next one. Ah! Every time! So not cool. Jump at the last second, huh? Okay, invisible pressure plates is very not like Dark Souls. Dark Souls is usually very upfront as to where its traps are. The fact that the pressure plate's invisible, I don't know, it seems a little like cheating. Oh, this place. Okay, I know where I am now. Okay, so what's further down here? It's the sleeping guard. Huh. Take that, sleeping guard. How dare you sleep on the job. Awesome. Oh, I hit him. This is like shooting cannons at a poor guy. Ah, I hit him again. He's at like 152 health, I think. Oh, he has like maybe a couple of points of health left. And now he's dead. Where does this go? Okay, this goes outside.